What's the latest with Celsius? You talked about some of these bankruptcies. Celsius, obviously, a big one that people are following.
Sure, yeah. So the latest that we've heard is that Ripple, which is sort of, you know, part of the XRP ecosystem, has said that they're interested in acquiring some of Celsius's assets. And they haven't really been clear about whether or not they want to acquire all of the company or just parts of their assets. What we do know from court filings is that Celsius is seeking to retain an investment banking firm to help sort of market their assets. And so in that scenario, what would happen is in a best case scenario, we would see something like a bidding process start in the coming weeks, in which case, you know, they'd try to have an auction set off where buyers would come in and bid. But we don't know how many other buyers there are at this point outside of Celsius.
David Hollerith, never a dull day in the crypto space. Appreciate you staying on top of the headlines there.
Hey, hey, everybody. It's Eddie from Tokyo. This is your cryptocurrency update from Japan and the Celsius token. Well, it's up 31%. The token soared, probably for three different reasons. First, the committee of the unsecured creditors, they claim that the CEO, Alex Mashinsky, repeatedly misled users about the safety of their funds. That has resulted in a 9-page statement that references specific tweets from Mashinsky as evidence. So I think some people are just feeling positive about some possible retribution that may come back then to benefit those sell holders. The second reason is there was also an organized short squeeze on Twitter. This is where people pile in hopes to recover some of their losses. It's very manipulative. It's very risky. And then as you saw from the intro clip, there's a story that Ripple is interested in the assets of the bankrupt crypto lender. Now, who would want a company with $1.9 billion in a deficit on their balance sheet? This spokesperson at Ripple said that they're interested in learning about Celsius and its assets and whether or not there is anything that could be relevant to their business. When I woke up this morning and saw the news, I have to tell you, I wasn't that surprised. On June 21st, 9 days after everything was frozen, I tweeted out that, yeah, I know, talk or rumor is no deal, but if a deal, I said, let me guess, 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the top four that I thought would be interested in acquiring some of those assets. First was Fidelity, second was JP Morgan, third, the Digital Currency Group, and fourth, Ripple. And I'm not thinking just Ripple solely, but maybe with some friends like SBI along with them. I've listened to a few videos and people are scratching their heads just wondering, what in the heck would Ripple be looking at? Well, shopping bankruptcy assets, it can be interesting. For example, you're going to get access to possibly their detailed customer list. You can also see the partnership agreements. That is some very interesting intel. There is also the chance that there is proprietary software. There's a participation in auctioned assets. Those usually come at fire sale prices. You also can see the licensing agreements. And maybe one of the most important for the liquidity hub, have a look at the past market volume data. You know, what it was that was selling, how much of it was selling, and to whom. That is really juicy information. Keeping it moving, there are three big stories from Japan that are not being picked up in the West. One is about XRP, one is about Ripple, and one is about the CFTC and Bitcoin. All three are mind-blowing because there's just crickets coming from the English written media. First, the CFTC, that is a regulator in the United States. They have approved a Bitcoin derivatives trading with a USD pair that has physical settlement. This is the first time that a cryptocurrency derivative has been approved as a swap execution facility. That's the kind of financial instrument it is. It's called an SEF. And yeah, it is physically settled. Where is the US media on this story? It broke 2 days ago. It's just crazy. And somebody in the comments said, well, this isn't happening in the United States, Eddie. Nobody really cares. No, 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 no. This is a US regulator giving the green light to a US company. This company is called Clear Markets, and they're located in North Carolina. I just don't get this at all. I couldn't even believe in the first 9 hours it hadn't been picked up by any US media. And now, 2 days later, still I can't find a story about it. I don't understand. So if you get it, please leave me some comment in the comment section. Explain it to me. The story about Ripple appeared with a featured interview with the global VP of strategy, Emi Yoshikawa. This is in a very popular IT media here in Japan. And she goes on to tell everyone that Ripple has a goal of just not doing remittances or facilitating easy access to liquidity pools of assets or NFTs, but the true goal is a world where various real-world assets are tokenized and a new economic zone is born around it. Ripple will prepare the infrastructure to realize that. This is a big play, everyone. And I think that most of the media in the West is just talking about how they're doing remittances and even downplaying that one use case. And as an XRP holder should know, when you create an economic zone, that means there are payments that are completely connected to that. And with the global world and with the digital asset XRP that bridges all of those global payments, this is a big deal. The third and final story for today is just yesterday, a bank in Japan called Shinsei Bank. They're a leader in home mortgages, time deposits, and foreign currency accounts, is offering your choice of Bitcoin or XRP. This is a campaign that started yesterday and it goes until the 31st of October. And they have these various tiered amounts. In the campaign overview, if you open a new account, you get a coupon for 500 yen. And then for a first-time login to the internet portal, another 500 yen coupon. And then a first deposit gives you a 500 yen coupon. If you set up your salary transfer, you get a 2,500 yen coupon. If you transfer an account registration, it's 1,000 yen. A foreign currency deposit is 1,000 yen. If you deposit more than 1,000,000 yen, that's like 7,500 US dollars, you're going to get a 2,000 yen coupon. Now, all these coupons are redeemable for either Bitcoin or XRP. You'll receive that crypto asset exchange coupon by email according to the transaction that you choose. And if you do them all, you're going to get around 8,000 yen of cryptocurrency. I think this is newsworthy because this is a full-fledged Japanese bank. And before we jump to the fluff, I want to tell you that John Deaton is continuing to add more people to his fight. This is now at 70,600. I think there is a big round number in the future that has five zeros. You go, John. We're jumping to the fluff, and I can't play this video because of the copyright restrictions, but it is definitely a video you want to see. There is a Japanese boy band. These are very common in Japan. They just do their best by singing and dancing their heart out on America's Got Talent. And Simon was, I think, taken aback by their performance. It's really, really worth seeing. I'm going to put a link to it in the description below. Enjoy. All right, everybody. Do take care. Sayonara for now. Bye-bye.